السلام عليكم، يعطيكم العافية. في محاضرة اليوم راح نكمل موضوع الـ Arrays in C Sharp. Last time we talked about one dimensional array. اليوم راح نحكي عن multi dimensional arrays. So the objectives of today's lecture understand the concept of multi dimensional arrays. Be able to create, populate and access multi dimensional arrays. Right? زي ما حكينا المرة الماضية في عندنا different types of arrays. حكينا المرة الماضية عن one dimensional array. اليوم بدنا نحكي عن المرة الماضية حكينا عن one dimensional array اللي هي عبارة عن row of elements. اليوم بدنا نحكي عن multi dimensional arrays. اليوم راح نشوف how can we create هاي multi dimensional array, how access the elements inside the multi dimensional array, and how can we populate the multi dimensional array. Okay. First of all, لما نحكي multi dimensional array شو يعني؟ معناته أنا لو إذا بحكي عن two dimensional arrays انا بحكي عن literal, انا بحكي عن table. Right? So احنا كأننا بنحكي عن table. ما بنهدر. Right? So احنا كأننا بنحكي عن اذا بنحكي عن two dimensional array, اذا بنحكي عن two dimensional array هي two D array, احنا شوي قاعدين نحكي عن table structure. اوكي, في عندنا rows وفي عندنا columns. اوكي, so this is for example, اذا كان the name of this two dimensional array is table. اوكي, بكون table هون عندنا بيأشر على table هون actually is a pointer to the first element في هاي الملتي دايمنشنال اري, بيأشر على اول ايلمنت اللي هو ايلمنت موجود في 0 0. هون في عندنا روز, هون في عندنا كولومز. هاي هون روز بكون هاي رو نمبر 0, هاي رو نمبر 0, رو نمبر 1 اند رو نمبر 2. اوكي, سو ذس وان از 1 and this one is row number 2. هون يكون عندنا column number 0, column number 1, number 2 and column number 3. So هاي هون في عندنا يكون rows and columns. هاي هون rows, انا بحب احكي rows and columns مش x و y. X Y بصير بتخربط. Alright. هيك الكولومز بتزيد, هيك الرو بتزيد. Okay. So this element, الإليمنت هاي اللي هون بكون 0 0. الإندكس تاع هاي الإليمنت اللي هون 0 0, وهاي الإليمنت اللي هون رو 0 كولوم 1. Alright. For example, إذا أخذنا هاي اللي هون فهي بتكون row 1 column 1. Right? Row 1 column 1, last one بتكون row 2 column 3. Okay? So this is a table 3 by 4 and there are 3 rows and 4 columns. Right? في الـ C Sharp إذا نعرف هذا الـ table عبارة عن pointer بيأشر على هاي الـ 2 dimensional array. نحكي هنا الـ table هاي equals new integer. For example, إذا كانت الـ elements type دعم integer, rows نحدد number of rows and نحدد number of columns, نستخدم comma بيناتهم. So one comma means 2 dimensional array. So here we have an integer and comma in the middle. It means that two dimensional. This is the first dimension and this is the second dimension. So this is two dimensional array. This is a two dimensional array. All right. Okay. Let's write a code. هاي بصير في عندنا هاي table, هو in this case في C sharp زي table is a pointer that's pointing to two dimensional array right. Now for more dimensions بصير عندنا 3 dimensions 4 dimensions نحط بدل x y z for example a b c which means that, that dimension a dimension b okay so in C sharp this is called the first dimension or dimension number 0 this is dimension number 1 so this is multidimensional with two dimensions this is the first dimension and this is the second dimension okay let's go to Visual Studio write a code and we have a class working with two dimensional arrays or working with multidimensional arrays And we have a public static method, so I'm working with two-dimensional arrays, the lecture, which is actually invoked from the main method in the program. All right. So our code will be here. I would say, let's write a code for two-D arrays. Right. Now if we run the program. We'll start from this statement. Okay, so now we need to see how can we create a two-dimensional array, public static. I'll say void now. Here, create 2D array. Now we need to create a 2D array, all right? So now 2D array or table is the same because table is a two-dimensional array. Create a table. Now I need the number of rows and number of columns. Number of rows and number of columns. And I need to return this array. So if it is integer, I would say that integer integer array with two dimension. So here we will create this array of two dimension. I would call it table equals new integer array with this number of rows and this number of columns. And that's it. Need to return here. I created a two-dimensional array and return it. Now this two-dimensional array is empty. I would say here create a table 3 by 4. So this statement will create a 2 3 by 4 table for me. Okay. Now if I want to print this table, print table, I would take this table as a parameter. I would say this is a table, and just iterate over the elements. This is void, I don't need to return anything. I can use the for statement for integer r equals 0, which means that so now I need r to iterate over the rows, and I need another for loop to iterate over the columns. So for integer r equals 0, now r less than an table, how do I know the number of rows in this table? We said that number of rows is the first dimension, so this is dimension number 0. Dot get length of this dimension, so integer dimension number 0, which is the first dimension. Now r plus plus, so this would iterate over the rows in this table. Now I need to do the same thing, I think, to iterate over the columns. For integer c equals 0, c is less than this table dot get length of 1, and now C plus plus. So here I just need to print out table of R and C. So table RC, which is the element, for example, 0, 0, this element, 0, 1, this element, and so on and so forth. Now space, and I want to make like a line between the rows. Good. So this is for a first row where this first for loop, it iterates over the rows, and this one iterates over the columns. Okay. Now let's print out this table. Print table. So here I would say that integer int table equals this one. Now I need to print this integer table. It should give me all zeros because nothing in this table. All right. Sorry. So now I don't need this one print line. I need this one to be in one line. I want to print each row in the same line. All right. So now let's try write a code. Now this is the table. Right. So three rows and four columns. Let's populate this there. Public static void. Let's populate this table. Right. I will take this integer table and this is, I would say, the table, and let's populate it with some random numbers. Okay, so again, if I want to access it the same way I access this table here, I would do the same thing here, but I don't want to print. I just need to add values to table of row and zero equals a random number. Okay. Now I can create a random object, rand equals new random. And here I can see just like a rand between 1 and 20. So just a random number between 1 and 20. Rand.next, sorry, dot next. Now let's populate this. Table and print it again. It's int table. Here, probably the int table. Sorry about that. Okay. So now here we populate this table with random numbers. So against three rows and four columns. So that's it for creating and populating integer tables. Again, we can do the same thing for example, we can use for each. We can use for each integer en table, all right? And then here we can print out, we can print out that element, all right? But if we do that, all of the elements will be printed in one line. Okay, I want to show you that. So here, all of the elements will be printed in one line. So now if we need to, all of the elements will be printed in, here. If we say like right, so now all of the elements will be printed in one line, okay. Same as this one, all right. All of the elements will be printed out here. We need just a new line, okay. So all of the elements will be printed in one line. So if we need to make a line break, okay. So if we need to make a line break, we have to initialize a variable and make a line every at the end of each column. I will not write the code for that. I will leave it for you. How can we use for each to write a code that looks like the code that's generated from those two for loops? Okay, thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed and you learned from today's lecture.